Now we move forward to the last theme of this group, which is simplifying cross-platform code blocks, IDE.
Good afternoon, everyone. First, let me introduce me and my group. I'm Tejasi Ladkar, Amok Kamat, Ronak Shah, Mansha Imtiaz. Every one of you must be familiar with code blocks. It is basically an open source C and C++ IDE. So our project was to simplify this IDE, keeping in mind the view of first years who are new to programming and have no prior knowledge of programming. So basically, simple blocks is built around the same platform as code blocks, and we removed all the complex functionalities of code blocks and included only the basic features like creating and saving a C++ file and running it, and basic editing features like cut, copy, paste, and complex features like the project notion, which is present in code blocks, has been removed. In addition to simplification of code blocks, we added some extra features in simple blocks. Like the simple CVP package has been integrated so that the user can run simple CVP programs easily. And a side pane has been added on the left hand side, which contains sample programs. And the user has a provision of updating this list. Like he can remove programs from it and add programs to it according to his needs. A help manual has been added to simple blocks, which can act as a reference to the user, and this is not present in code blocks. And on opening a new C or C++ file, a basic skeleton code appears. So what was the motivation of our project and selecting code blocks for simplification? So first and foremost, code blocks is an open source software, and it is widely used in engineering colleges all over India. And as I mentioned previously, the complex features of code blocks, like the project notion and management of plugins, such concepts are very confusing and complex for a first year who doesn't know anything about programming. So these have been removed. And the management of plugins, adding and removing plugins, this is also very complicated for a first year. So we included some basic plugins as default, and the user has no provision of adding or removing any plugins in the IDE. We also integrated S++, that is the compiler for simple CPP. And there is only one basic default compiler with S++ integrated, obviously. And code blocks has many compilers, so the user has to select one compiler. Simple CPP has only one compiler, so that the user doesn't have to change the compiler each time he wants to run a simple CPP program or C program. And lastly and most importantly, code blocks has a very good GUI, so that is why we selected code blocks. And IDEs like Turbo C, the interface is not very good, and IDEs like Vim Editor, they are very confusing for a first year. So that is why code blocks is the best for simplification. I'll now call upon Mansha Imtiaz, who will tell us about installation of simple blocks.
Now, CodeBlocks uses C++ and WX widgets for its development and for providing GUI. So we have used the same thing for simple blocks as well. Next thing, the main thing actually, while simplifying CodeBlocks, it was to reduce the number of installation steps. When we install CodeBlocks from source, there are many steps. So it's a cumbersome job for a beginner to install the software. So with the simplification, we have reduced the step to just one command. It is just one command installation. So the user just has to go to the directory and just type one command in the terminal, and the software installs. And he can access the software from the dashboard in case of Ubuntu. And in case of Windows, the user just has to click on the .exe file. Now the GUI will be explained by Ronak.
Okay, so I'll explain the changes done in CodeBlocks to SimpleBlocks. So initially in code blocks, there were so many menus you can see. So we didn't require the projects menu or the debug menu. So we removed all the menus from there. And this side pane has been added, which contains the sample programs. Now, as you can see, the file menu has been reduced to a much greater extent. We've added this functionality, like in new, we have create a C file, C++ file, simple CPP file. So when you click on either of them, it opens this basic skeleton and also gives an option to save a file. Most of the options were not necessary actually, like bookmarks, or you didn't need to save any to-do items or so. In search, a first year doesn't use any of these functions, like go to function or so. He writes a 10 line code or 20 lines code, max 100. So that doesn't require a go to function or go to notes or something. So this has been removed. And a first year also doesn't, as in he doesn't require too many files so that they can be built or so. So the projects has been removed completely. The build has been reduced to just compile and run. So there is no build notion anyways. So just compile and run. And we're not giving any settings to him. So, and this help manual has been added actually. It wasn't there initially in code blocks. Yeah, this is the help manual. Now, Ronak will explain the remaining.
So as all of you saw how the menu bar had been changed in the simple blocks, from code blocks to simple blocks. In a similar way, there were various toolbars, the menu toolbar and the compile toolbar. So well, the few options have been removed and we have just only kept the limited options. There was also a debugger toolbar which has been completely removed, as the debug feature has been completely removed, because in first year, no one actually uses a debug. In a factorial program, where are you just going to go and debug, you're just going to read the code. Then there was also an autocomplete toolbar which has been completely removed, which was actually a plugin which has been removed from code blocks itself in simple blocks. So there was also a management pane. Now since the project notion has been removed, we removed the management pane completely. An important feature which was added was the sample programs. A left pane appears on the simple block screen which contains the sample programs. So in default installation itself, when a person installs simple blocks, the whichever programs, this was made for the EDX thing, like when a code starts on EDX or by DB Fartek sir. So if whichever sample programs if he wants to give, like while installation, he can give those sample programs in the folder which in the installation thing which we are providing. All those programs will be copied to the documents folder of the user's computer. And over here, we have actually just masked it that it will search for the sample programs folder in the documents folder of the user's computer. Everything which is over there will be shown in this thing. So even if a user, like after I write a program and I think it is important, or I want it to be in my sample programs, even if he's an advanced user, suppose I have an algorithm for finding out a sum in an array, I just want to store it over here in my sample programs, I can do that over here. Here we have even masked it that it only searches for C, CPP and simple CPP files. So only those files will be visible in this pane which are have an extension of .c, CPP or simple CPP. All those other files do not have those extensions will not be visible. Then even the log, there was a debugger log over there which have been removed because the debugger feature has been completely removed. Then execution of simple CPP programs. This was one of the important features which has been added to the simple blocks. In code blocks, if you had to run a simple CPP programs in code blocks, you had to go to the settings bar and you had to change the compilers, you had to provide paths for the S++ compiler, the directory paths for the, for people out, everyone who doesn't know simple CPP uses turtle and it shows graphic features. This like you write a code and like this is a simple CPP code, like it uses a turtle type thing and in this case a polygon is being formed. So like you have a snake application, you can create graphic programs using simple CPP. It has been created by Professor Ranade, he's a professor in IIT Bombay. So this whole simple CPP, its compiler, everything has been created by him. And so our main job was to integrate it with simple blocks so that if someone, in simple blocks, if he just writes a simple CPP program, it gets executed without making any changes to a compilers or anywhere. So that's it.
Also, we have reduced the code size from 193 MBs to 25 MB. So that is also.
That was my question. What MB you are talking about? What is the size you are talking about?
The size of the source code.
I have never heard anybody talk about the size of the code.
No, actually, this software package, when we install it from the site of code blocks, it is 193 MBs, which gets installed in your system. So that the size, the memory that it takes from your system is 193 MBs. But now it will just take 25 MB.
I don't care about that. So how much code have you removed?
We have removed all the extra functionalities and we have removed all the code for that.
How many lines of code you started with and how many are you left with? And how many have you added? That you have to have. That without that, there is nothing. Well, I don't know whether you have added any code at all.
So we have provided the documentation of all the files we have changed. all the, not the lines of code, but all the files we have changed and the functionality that has been removed from that file.
Change is a different matter. Have you actually removed code?
Yeah, we have.
But as we have removed the from the XRCs, it doesn't link to anything. So that reduces the code. It doesn't call anything or those files are not.
No, there is a method for what you have done and you have not followed the correct method. If I have to remove the code, okay, I have to sort of remove the functionality. There are various ways of doing it.
Right.
Okay. Now the correct way to do it is only using something called your C preprocessor. Okay. This is a hash ifdef command. Have you used that? If you have not used that, then you have not done the correct job. Okay. Basically, if there is a whole set of C code and you are modifying a C IDE without knowing C, okay, all I need to do is if def code blocks hash end if. Okay, that's all that is required to drop that code. So it's the same code as before, and I can define it on the command line. Okay, so that with the same code I can actually create a code blocks as well as simple blocks, simple blocks both possible during compile. I don't have to touch the source code except add these statements. Okay, the normal way people use these statements is to write your OS dependent code. If OS is Windows, then use this code. If OS else, use this code. So you are aware of that. You should have used that technique.
So okay. We have developed for one OS only, like we.
No, doesn't matter. But that particular technique of hiding code using ifdef is what you should have used. The advantage is, if code blocks come with a new version, what am I supposed to do? I'm not going to do your chop on another set of whatever 100,000 lines.
Sir, okay. This simplification won't be required for all the versions.
Why?
Sir, the basic specification that was provided was just to reduce.
I know, but if code block does something else, adds a command which I want to include, I'm not going to do that. Every software, every piece of software in the world goes through alias. Okay. What you have done is, you should have taken a code block branch, code block code, 1.2.0 code. Now you have branched it off to 2.1. When code block comes to 3.0, I have to go to 3.1. There should be a mechanism.
When code blocks goes from, right now it's 13.12 to 14 point something.
Correct.
It adds some functionality like plugins and all that. That won't be needed in the simple blocks.
I want it. What is the
problem?
Then
the purpose of simplification is lost. Because
why? Because it might be simple functionality.
But the simple functionality won't be added at 13.12 or so.
Why not?
The thing is that like when we go from...
cannot dictate how code block will evolve.
Will evolve like from 13.10 to 13.12, it evolves like adding some plugin. Like there's a development going on.
There's a rule that you have imposed on code block writers that you have to only add plugins, nothing else you can add.
I'm just giving an example of plugin, but they will just improve the functionality. They will not go in the backwards. So
why you're going backwards?
The simplification is the backward process. Why? We have just simplified it. We have just given the basic default.
I'm very
structure.
Sorry. You added sample example files.
So basically, you are telling us that if a version is being introduced by code blocks, we have to give a process to automate the simplification process.
You have to have used the version control system. Have you used version control system? Still, you are not. Correct.
So if we see the code for 10.12 and 13.12 of code blocks, there is a huge of difference. Even the size is different. Means they have added a lot of things over there, and they have maybe they have just changed the main file is completely changed. So how can we just give like if and just give it like if this is there then introduce it? Like there's a lot of change like in main even just let's just take main.cpp file. Even in between the systems 10.12 and 13.12 it will be different. They won't be having the same things again and again. Maybe they will just...
Wait. You don't understand. You have got set of 1000 lines of C code. You want to remove 500 of them. Okay. In some 500, you have actually deleted them, which is absolutely wrong because you don't know what they are. Okay, then somebody, I think some intelligent person told you, no, original people should see. So now you have commented it.
Yeah.
That itself is wrong. All the 1000 lines should remain. Fresh lines have to be added, which are hash ifdef and hash endif. And a compiler has to be used to generate code blocks as well as simple blocks with a simple command line option. That is the only way to do it. There is no other way. Okay, professional way to do it. Okay, not comment, not remove. The code does not belong to you. And secondly, how did you comment it? Now let me see. It's very difficult to comment code. I want to see how you did it.
Okay, we searched for the functionalities linked, how this code is linked with this code. That was the challenge that
how
we faced.
How did you comment the existing code?
It is C++ and .xrc.
It is not possible in C++.
Sir, it...
Because C++ has a comment called /*, and a */. And I can include it in every line. I write it in every line. People have seen my code. Okay. All I need to do is .c to .cpp, it works. So, it, C++ includes C. Okay. So, if I got /* in every line, you cannot comment it. It's as simple as that. I give you 10 definitions, each variable having a comment, what that variable does. Comment these 10 lines for me. Just not possible. If you have, then code block is not written by a good programmer. As simple as that.
So, because that was the thing that we followed.
Try and comment my code and you will see you will not be able to comment it.
So, we have been...
I only use /* and */. I do not use the newfangled //. Okay. // can be commented with /*. /*, cannot be commented out at all. Okay. Anyway, I have no further questions. But anyway, your software is good.